So today we're here at Weld.com Lab, and I got Melton Metal Anthony with me. We picked up a little side job we're going to do on some handrail. So we're going to build a handrail at the lab. So what do you think, Anthony?
Today we're going to be building some DOT handrail. We're going to be using some 2.5-inch OD pipe. And we're going to go ahead and weld this together over here at the lab. And me and my good buddy Paul, we're going to do the install after. But first, let's just get this stuff carried in, I guess, huh?
Yeah, let's get it carried in, do our layout, and get to working on it.
All right. See, that there is doctor writing. I get paid like a doctor. I ain't smart as one. You for sure measured from center to center on that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
20 3/8
center of your top rail, center of your mid rail is 18 inches.
Okay, so 20 3/8 we need. And then that's times 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're going to have to figure out the cope first because the cope isn't going to come completely halfway over the pipe. It's only going to cover like, what, a third of the pipe? And then a third will be left in the middle?
It should, yep.
Yeah.
Yep. Something around there.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we just took some 1/8 filler rod, and what we did was you clipped them down to roughly 6 inches each. We're going to wrap them around our piece of pipe, and we're just going to make a coping jig real quick. The only thing I can't remember is how to hold them in place without them falling out like that. So I guess I'll figure that out as I go.
There's going to be somebody who comments, "You idiots, you do it like this."
Oh, I'm sure. Yeah. Everybody's always got a bigger, better way, but you know what?
They might, though.
Yeah, they do.
They really might.
They do.
On this one, they might actually have a better way.
Right.
All right, here we go. Now it looks like I might know what I'm talking about. The problem is we didn't cut them all to the same length. Yeah, if they were all cut to the same length, this would be a little... That's hard good.
Yeah.
That's the good tape there. You can't just tear it.
Yeah.
That's that expensive Weld.com tape. All right, so we made us a fish mouth stencil. So we're going to go over here and just check it out, make sure it looks right.
We'll mark it out, and then...
You want to just cut one and then test it?
Of course.
This is real rough. It ain't perfect, but I ain't perfect.
Right. What does it look like over there?
It's definitely a little deeper than the fish mouth you were cutting earlier.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Exactly what I'm saying. So we could just take the grinder into it, cut...
Yep.
Triangles out of it and then go ahead.
Exactly.
All right, so you want to cut it here first or you want to do, actually, you know what? Let's cut the fish mouth on this because we got this damn thing to hold it for us. So after we clean that cope up, we're going to go ahead and we're going to take it over to the plastic folder we have and we're going to make that into our template so we can wrap it around the existing pipe or the pipe we're using and then trace around that. And then that'll, you know, that'll be it. Now, it doesn't really matter the orientation of the fish mouths. I can put them on however I want because these ends of the pipe will be in the ground. These are our posts. Only one end of the fish mouth matters. And then our horizontal pipes are gonna be fish mouthed into this. So I can just go ahead and trace these out however I want. For the sake of, because Weld.com's got all these tools and I ain't got none of them, I'm gonna see if plasma cutting these copes is faster than just using a grinder and a flap disc, which is what I have to do on a regular basis. But like I said, they got the Tomahawk 375 Air from Lincoln, so we're gonna give her a shot, huh? All right, let's start cutting these things. Even with my horrible inexperience and my terrible plasma cutting skills, it seems that the plasma cutter is a little faster, so I'm moving all my pipe over here, and that's how we're going to do it.
So Anthony showed you how to make a template for the copes. I'm going to show you how to make a template for the 90, which is really simple. So I cut the 90 on the saw. I made sure the saw was a true 90. So I cut a piece, or this is a drop. So we got a true 90, and what I'll do is I'm going to take this plastic cover, cut it, wrap it around the piece, tape it, mark it from the inside, take it off, unravel it, take the tape off, cut it out, and then we'll have our template for our 90s. So I showed you how to make the 90 degree template. So I slid it on the pipe, and of course I have my measurement, which is right here. I put a wraparound around it, put my mark. So I lined it up with my template, and I'm gonna mark it. After I mark it, I'll slide it back in the saw, go down to that end, because it's already got the 45 on it, and make sure that 45 is level. So when you level that 45, and you coincide with the blade here, both 45s will be level. So when you go to put it together, they're not all cattywampus and off and everything. So it's pretty close. So that's what you want to do. You want to make sure before you make this cut on this end that that 45 is level. Yep. So we got all the cutting done, finally, measuring, coping, 45 and 90s. And now we're gonna start laying out. So me and Anthony learned a lot about this coping thing and how everything needs to be on center, center punching, and everything needs to be precise. Didn't we learn that?
Oh yeah.
Which wasn't hard. So anyway, Anthony's gonna take it from here and he's gonna show you the blueprint and how he's got it laid out, and we're gonna put it on his table, tack it or hold it down with the clamps and stuff. That's what another thing I like about this Sigmund Quantum table. Is it's really good for this kind of fabrication work, and it works really well. And we're gonna use the heck out of it. So what do you think, Anthony?
I think this table's making this project a breeze. I mean, I'm excited to get this thing jigged up on this table and use it. I certainly don't have anything like this at my home shop, and I mean, hey, send me one. But yeah, no, I mean, this is gonna make it a breeze. We got our little hand-drawn blueprint. I love this graph paper. It makes life as a mobile welder and a guy who does a lot of fab work a little bit easier, just a little bit. I mean, it's not, what do you call that on the computer there?
CAD.
It's not CAD, but it works for me.
It's paper CAD.
Yeah, I mean, for what we're doing here, we're just making some basic DOT railing. This is perfectly fine. So we're gonna go ahead, run off our measurements here and start jigging this thing up on the table.
Too much right there. Yeah. Actually, a little less.
It's fine. That should be fine. Ain't going nowhere.
Yeah.
That's the thing you got to be careful of, is it's a little finicky. It'll start moving on you.
Mm-hmm.
Is it good?
Pretty damn close, dude.
Okay.
Close enough for what we're doing.
All right.
Good?
Yep.
All right.
So we've taken all our measurements center to center. That's why you see me and Paul getting everything measured on center to center, because we have to put these rails back in existing holes. What had happened was, with the original rails, somebody rammed into them, knocked them out of place, blew the concrete out, and now we need to put these back in, reinforce the concrete with rebar. Well, it's gonna be one heck of a job. So we need to make sure everything is lined up and ready to go. So when we get out into the field, we're not trying to core drill or drill new holes or jackhammer out a bunch of concrete. We want these things to slip in so we can just backfill them with concrete and be on our way and take care of it real fast.
Eyeball.
You good?
Yep.
Now we're welding. So I'm using a Lincoln Electric 255C power MIG. Right now we are at 20 volts, 455 inches per minute. We have everything else off on this machine. We have it set up on the four-step trigger, but the spot time, the run-in, and the burn back are all off right now. We're using 100% argon, and we're using a spool gun.
So today I'm running the Aspect 375. I'm doing the heliarching on the end with the corners. So we'll go through the settings. I'm using the AC with the high freak, TIG, using 2T. We'll go through the AC frequency. I got the frequency on 110, balance on 70. The EP positive is 163. EN negative is on 137. Of course, automatic off. So I got my amps on 145. So I'm running E3 tungsten 332 diameter with 4043 332 diameter wire, 100% argon. So let's get it welded out. As you can see, we finished the handrail job and we started in the shop, fabbed in the shop. Of course, brought it out in the field and installed it. Had fun doing it.
It was a good time.
It was a good time.
No, it's a pleasure working with you, Paul. I mean, you're a guy that really is a well-rounded individual. You know, you're not just a welder. That's rare to find.
Thank you.
It really is.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Any people out there got comments or anything, put them down below. Thanks for watching today.